Oh, tekan. Saya nak rekod 4 minit video. Anda rasa berapa lama saya ambil untuk rekod 4 minit video? 4 jam. Mungkin lately anda nampak saya banyak aktif dekat dalam Instagram, Facebook, TikTok dan juga YouTube. Kalau anda tengok kan, saya dengan video ni, I used to have a very hate relationship lah dengan video. Saya ni jenis yang sangat-sangat pemalu bila ada orang nak tangkap video saya. Memang saya akan lari jauh-jauh. Even like my wife kalau nak just record a video, the two of us pun saya akan lari. Sebab saya memang sangat-sangat tak suka tengok muka saya dekat dalam video. And that's just me. And I know that I have struggled with this problem for quite a while. Pada bulan November 2018, at that time saya nak shoot my first video. Kenapa saya nak shoot my first video? Sebab at that time because I'm a licensed financial planner, so di mana saya nak kongsikan tips-tips kewangan, saya nak gunakan video sebagai media pengantara. And saya record video saya. Saya ingat lagi time tu waktu malam in my office lah, my home office. And guess what? Oi, teka kan? Saya nak record 4 minit video. Anda rasa berapa lama saya ambil untuk record 4 minit video? 4 jam. 4 jam. Bayangkan saya spend 4 jam daripada pukul 6 petang sampai pukul 11 malam hanya nak rekod 4 minit video. But just to show you how unproductive I was at that time. And saya memang sangat-sangat stress. And what happened is, coincidentally, saya dapat this random WhatsApp message daripada, you know, my mentor lah. At that time, saya tak kenal dia. Dia hantar kat saya, dia buat kelas bagaimana nak shoot video. So, it just so happened. And then, saya buat apa? Saya sign up, saya terus pergi ke kelas dia. And then, saya pergi kelas dia pada bulan 11, hari bulan Januari 2019. And that was the start that I begin to involve in video creation. Fast forward to right now, kenapa saya pilih YouTube? Sedangkan saya memang dah aktif dekat dalam Facebook, Instagram saya, sebab saya rasa YouTube is like the Google of video. Di mana kalau content-content saya yang saya release, kalau saya release dekat dalam YouTube, orang dapat tengok video tu walaupun setahun daripada sekarang, 5 tahun daripada sekarang, 10 tahun daripada sekarang, malah 20 tahun daripada sekarang pun anda masih lagi boleh tengok video-video saya. And then that's the main reason kenapa I choose YouTube. It's because I want to reach out to more people. Thanks to all your comments dalam Facebook, dalam Instagram, dalam YouTube. It means a lot to me because I feel that apa-apa saya kongsikan, benda yang saya kongsikan sangat-sangat bermanfaat dan saya nak reach out to new people. To new people yang maybe anda tak tengok Facebook, anda tak follow Instagram, tetapi anda masih lagi use Google untuk search. So for example, macam mana nak invest, and anda akan nampak video saya. And it means a lot to me to be able to share you my opinion in a certain topic. So that's one of the main reason why I choose venture into YouTube. And not only that lah, I've heard a lot of stories that YouTube platform dia macam agak up sikit lah. Okay, lebih credible if you have a YouTube presence. A lot of all these famous people like Tony Robbins, Robert Kiyosaki, Gary Vee, they are all big people in the industry. They have very strong presence dekat dalam YouTube. And you know, insyaAllah I'll be the next. Okay, so that's from me, kenapa saya buat free content YouTube. But what do you guys think? Okay, what do you guys think about orang-orang yang buat video dekat dalam YouTube ni? Apa pendapat anda? Sila komen dalam video. And saya just nak tahu. Okay, saya just nak tahu. And I'll see you in my next video.